Welcome to King Faisal Specialist Hospital and Research Center. Established in the year 2000, it has been striving for perfection ever since. Under the wise leadership of Dr. Tariq Linjawi, the hospital has made its mark on the local and international medical community. Today, we will be taking a virtual tour of the Department of Pathology and Laboratory Medicine at the hospital. Under the direction of Dr. Nabil Albaz, the laboratory facility is an essential part of the hospital, providing quality patient care and maintaining international standards. Please join us now for a virtual tour of our laboratory. The story begins here. This is the lab reception where patients are greeted by professional caregivers. Each patient request is received and verified by patient name, medical record number, and the tests required. All this information is integrated into the laboratory information system, which among other things generates a unique barcode label for each tube required. The labels are handed over to our qualified phlebotomists, who double-check patient information and draw the required blood into the appropriate tubes. The lab reception also receives inpatient and referral samples routinely. Follow us into the specimen processing area where patient samples are sorted, processed, and delivered to each individual section. This area is also responsible for sorting samples to be sent to outside institutes for special testing. This area is called the Biochemistry Department. Here, qualified technologists use the most technologically advanced autoanalyzers to test patient samples for electrolytes, glucose, enzymes, and hormones. The biochemistry lab also performs toxicology testing. Here, we come to the serology laboratory, where testing for HIV, hepatitis, and autoimmune diseases takes place. Technologists here use state-of-the-art instruments to test patients and blood donors regularly. Over here, we find the hematology section of our laboratory. Here, blood cell counts and white blood cell differential counts are performed on the most advanced hematology analyzers in the market. A team of highly trained technologists manually reviews microscopic slides for a wide range of hematological disorders. Blood clotting disorders and anticoagulant monitoring are also investigated here, using top-of-the-line equipment. Hemoglobinopathy disorders are routinely investigated here, as well as premarital screening for genetic disease. Bone marrow aspirates and stains are also processed in this department. Next, we come to the Transfusion Services Department. Blood donors are required to answer a questionnaire and be screened before being allowed to donate, thus ensuring only quality blood units to be obtained. A single blood donor can provide 450 mL of whole blood or 600 mL of platelet concentrate by apheresis. The freshly drawn units are then transferred to the component section for further process. Here, blood units are centrifuged and separated into packed red blood cells and plasma. Apheresis or platelet units are screened for infectious agent. All blood products are then transferred to the blood bank where they are tested for blood type and antibodies before being labeled for patient transfusion. Next, we reach the microbiology lab, where our dedicated technologists test patient samples for infectious agents. This area covers bacteriology, mycobacteriology, mycology, and parasitology, as well as routine urinalysis. In this area, the assisted reproduction technology department, infertile couples are treated to have their own biological child. The female is stimulated hormonally to produce more than one egg. The eggs are extracted and mixed with the husband's sperm in vitro. Once fertilized, the resulting embryo is then transferred into the female's uterus and allowed to grow naturally. If the husband's sperm count is low, a special technique called intracytoplasmic sperm injection is used. With this method, all steps of natural fertilization are bypassed and a single sperm is directly inserted into the cytoplasm of the oocyte. Whether the fertilization is natural or assisted, in vitro fertilization increases a couple's chance of pregnancy by 40%. Here we come to the anatomical pathology lab where we find the histology and cytology sections. These sections are devoted to the study of functional and structural changes in cells, organs, and tissues that underlie disease. Samples received and processed in this lab include biopsies, body fluids, and fine needle aspirates. Here we find the flow cytometry laboratory. This area deals with hematological malignancies, immunophenotyping, and lymphoproliferative disorders. State-of-the-art flow cytometers are used to study peripheral blood, bone marrow aspirates, tissue masses, and lymph node extracts for cellular subsets and disease states and prior to transplants. All the sections we have visited cannot perform outside the boundaries of quality control. Since 2002, the Department of Pathology and Laboratory Medicine has been accredited by the College of American Pathologists and the American Association of Blood Banks. The strict guidelines of these two internationally acknowledged institutes govern the activities of this facility. Through vigorous on-site inspections, the quality aspects of our lab are put to the test. In an effort to share the acquired knowledge of the facility, the Department of Pathology and Laboratory Medicine organizes many educational programs. These programs include continuing education sessions for the staff, hospital grand rounds, and the medical technology diploma program. We have seen how the lab functions on an internal level. Externally, the lab routinely conducts collaborative meetings with other departments in an effort to standardize the services we provide. The lab routinely accepts and receives referral specimens from other institutes and clinics. Our financial department makes the proper arrangements in regards to sample delivery and payments made to our lab. Overseeing the activities of the Department of Pathology and Laboratory Medicine are a team of experienced pathologists whose knowledge and support are essential for the continuous quality service the lab extends within the hospital and without. Drawing near the end of our tour, we have seen how a world-renowned lab functions on a daily basis. Through a diverse team of professionals, the lab continuously provides quality care to patients throughout the region. We hope you have enjoyed this virtual tour and hope to see you soon. Goodbye.